Hello everyone, and welcome to my first redstone tutorial. In this video I'm going to be showing you how to make this 3x3 enchanting station. The redstone is a tiny 9x9x15, so it should fit somewhere into your base. And also I need to give credit to Myzuma Games for the top half of this contraption, which is a triple piston extender. I'll put a link to that video in the description. So let's get the tutorial started. So for the start of this tutorial we're going to have a 9x9 area, as I said at the start. We're going to have our floor along here, if you can just see. So this row here will not have any blocks on redstone. The block above is where the 15 starts, so from the yellow to the yellow, that is 15 blocks. This is the floor, so you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then your floor. The red's where your bookshelves are going to go, and that's where your enchanting table's going to go. So then we're going to start making this first. We're going to do that there, which is the input. Then we're going to go over to the bottom half of the pistons. And then we're going to start with the top part, the main part. I put a button here for testing. I don't know why I did not get rid of that. This yellow line here is useless. That quartz is there. I don't know. I was testing fixing a problem that I had. I had to change this one up a bit to that one because it would not work. It's exactly the same, but it didn't work. So, okay. One thing, if you see that recording ball there, that is just my replay mod that I've got going. You're gonna be able to see an above thing like this in the top corner, one of the top corners of the screen. I'm actually probably gonna put that over that recording thing, so you're not gonna see that actually. So yeah, that'll help you. So what we're going to do is we're going to go 3 blocks to the side, 3 blocks gap, we're going to place 3 blocks like that, 1 block here, go up like this. Alright, so we have this shape, and this is just the input to the bottom half. Usually I would go to the pressure plates first, but this is just on the floor, so it's easier. We're going to place a redstone torch right here, 2 redstone like that, another block here, redstone repeater, and we're going to place an orange block right here with a torch on top of that. So this is where you're going to the start of the thing is going to start. So now we need to... Okay, so I'm just going to be looking over here a few times because I have not memorized this at all. Like, no, I haven't. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up 2 blocks here. We're going to have blocks there. So we've got this weird L shape like this. This yellow shape. I'm just going to get... Goodbye. Okay, unorganized. Right, so this is the line here we're making. We go one past here, redstone all on top like that. We're going to have a 1 tick repeater there, 2 tick repeaters right there, just like this. Above here we're going to place 3 blocks and 3 pressure plates. Now we're going to go over here. Actually 2 pistons do actually push blocks out past the area, so make sure you have space there. Hopefully you do. Hopefully that's not a new thing. It's, you know, a block under the floor block, so it shouldn't mess you up too much if you're going to have your wall like right here maybe. I don't know. So now what you're going to do is you're going to place a piston just like this with a block on top. So this is going to be your T flip-flop, so when you stand on this... Whoops, silly me, I did not. Make sure you place another block there with redstone on top. That will give you a T-flip-flop, so it goes out, and then it goes back on again. So that is perfect. Now what we're going to do is place a redstone block right, a block there, right there, with a redstone torch on top, like that. And then if I come back over here, we're going to make this thingy hit here. We're going to go out on this block. We're going to go out right there. This is going to have a slab here so it does not power that piston. Then one more block like that. Sorry if I'm being terrible at this. And then we're just going to fill in the rest of these blocks like so. I've already forgotten the ticks on the repeaters. I'm so bad at memorizing stuff. So this is going to be 1 tick, and then we're going to have a 4 tick here and a 3 tick here, like that. This is going to go into a piston right there, and then this is the other block that goes out, so hopefully most likely do have space out there. Now we're going to place a block right there like that with redstone just over there. Block here, redstone torch on top, block there, block on top, redstone repeater coming out there just like that with a slab there so it does not power this piston and do any weird things. Redstone out of there with a nice L shape with another slab there. No, why did I say slab there? I was looking at that. No, we don't need a slab here. Just like that. Redstone out like this, and then we're gonna go back to this part here, so blocks along like this, one block up like that, redstone here, and then a 3-tick and a 2-tick repeater. 1, 2, 3, 2. So 3 ticks like that, 2 ticks like this, into that block. Another orange block here, and then that should be your input system. Nope, not yet. Under this slab here, we're going to place a piston with a redstone block on top. So, and also redstone there and there. So now, redstone will go through that and power that somehow. I don't know, it doesn't power that one there, but it does power this one there, so I'm glad that that happened. And we should be finished. Those will both turn on, if I'm correct. No. What have I got wrong? Nope, that's right, I think. What the heck happened there? I think it's working. So that one's on, that one's off, right? That turns off, which means the bookshelves will go up, that will do nothing, and then when we turn this, the bookshelves will go on, and that flashed right there. That is the input, mostly, well, yes, completely done. Okay, I don't know why I had two glass blocks there, I was expecting to do the same thing as here, but no, we're just going to build off this. So now we're going to place a block on top like that with redstone torches on either side like that. Then we're going to go down a block down and over there. We're going to go in. Yes, that's green. We're going to go in, out, and then along. So it's four blocks here. And yes, I also forgot a stone slab on the bottom of this block. That with redstone on top there. That is so that the redstone that we're going to place down here as well. What the heck am I doing? Chop that off the edge. So the bottom here, we're going to go into that block right there, and we're going to take redstone out like that. That is so that this does not power that block and just do anything to this redstone here. So now we're going to place redstone along here like that, hopefully I'm right, and then same on this side, apart from the fact that we're not going to have our slab down like that. So after the slab we're going to place a block. I'm doing this on the opposite side, aren't I? Yes I am. That does not matter. Whatever side you choose to do this thingy on, you can do it on either side, having the slab go down. We're going to place a torch on top like that, another block here with a torch there, and there, blocks above, and then more blocks coming out like this, and three should be enough for this side, and then we're just going to come all the way out around the back. Pistons are going to be along here. Actually, I forgot to do that. We need to power the back line, so what am I doing? Like this. Yes. Lot there and another lot there, and then over here we're gonna have redstone coming out. I'm doing this completely wrong. This. No. I have no idea what I'm doing. Like this. finally. That is so correct, I think. So we're going to place six pistons like that with regular pistons on top, more sticky pistons with regular pistons on top, more pistons, and more regular pistons on top. So that should be correct, I hope. Yes. Redstone in the back here. It doesn't want me to place it. Oh, I see. So it doesn't want me having redstone there, so what I'm going to do is just take this redstone around here like that. Hopefully that won't be 15 blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 13. Okay. And then that one is absolutely fine. So that should be this, most of this done. More redstone there. Don't need that. Yes, we do. Of course we do. Redstone around here, like this. Lucky that piston will not be powered by any of this redstone, because there is no block below it. And then more redstone along like this, and that should be this part done, if we just give it a test. Oh, I see. We don't have the middle layer here. I failed so badly. Let me just turn this. So we have a triple piston extender without any retraction at all. But that is absolutely fine. So let's get on with the yellow part. Okay, so for this part here, I'm going to be looking over there a lot, because this is the part that MyZuma Games designed. I have changed it a little bit so the signal would move over here. This part here, like this little section here, and this redstone going along here. Make sure these blocks are aesthetically pleasing to you, by the way. Yeah, the signal strength only gets to there. Then that's the 16th. It's the 15th when this repeater powers, but then when that repeater powers, it only makes it to there, and then that completely stuffs up the whole thing. So I had to find a way around that. I couldn't put that repeater like forward anymore, because then that piston would be powered, and I was just, you know, it took me hours to figure this out. And then more happened, where it would derp out and those pistons would go, and then those ones would go, even though they're powered by the exact same redstone, like that. No repeaters anywhere. It still thought that somehow there was a repeater there, and those went first, and then those went second. I think that was just some sort of buddy thing with signal strength. So then I tried to just change it to quartz, because it was similar to that one. Well, exactly the same. Everything was the same, but for some reason it wanted to derp out and not work at all. So yeah, I fixed it, and to fix that problem with those going, I just added an extra signal strength on everything. That repeater used to be there, that repeater wasn't there at all, and it just redstone went straight around. So now I actually need to get rid of that, because I don't think I need that anymore, and just do that. So I'm just going to test this. Yep, that works. Okay. Yeah, so what we're going to do is place yellow wool right there and another block right there, I hope. See, told you I'm going to be looking over at... Yes, that's right. Now I have people making big noises and I'm recording. Okay. Block right there. More redstone slabs there, hopefully, like that, yes. And then we're going to have another one up there, and then one more like that, so going up like that, and then one more right there, so that is the same height. And then over here, what we're going to do is have a regular block there with another slab. Nope, no slab. that like that. We're gonna go here and place 3-4 slabs long. 1, 2, 3. Like that. And then we can have the regular blocks along around the edges. So 1, 2, 3. Yes, and then we're gonna go more 1, 2, 3. More 1, 2, 3. Put our redstone along here like this. Hope you guys are following. You should be. I tried to make this extremely easy to watch. We have this right here. Redstone there, that there, that there. Repeater there, that's on 4 ticks. Okay, so that is that done. Now we're going to go down to the bottom line. We have a block there, I think. Okay, block there, block here. Why is that invisible? Let me fix that for you. There we are. That is... why am I looking? I know. It's 2 ticks. This is 3 ticks. No! That is 3 ticks and that is 4 ticks. I had to change it. Right. Did. And then you're gonna have your redstone go in like that. And then once again, box like that. I don't know why I go in like that. If you want, you can do that. It won't mess up the system at all. 1, 2, 3. This is where you're not gonna... No, you need this one connected the full way through because you have more stuff along here. So that's gonna be going all the way around. And then once we get to the last one, then you're just gonna go straight along there, I think. Of course I'm not correct. That doesn't even need to be there. No, we're gonna go out an extra 2 blocks past where the piston's gonna be, so that's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. I am super sorry. Like, that is a new word. Super sorry that I'm being so annoying. Annoying. Why did I say that? Okay, then we're gonna go down a block here. Redstone there. 2 blocks. That there. 4 tick repeater like this. Block there. Redstone like this. Another block out here. With a block there, we're gonna go down around like this. I'm pretty sure we're gonna have 4 tick repeater and a 3 tick repeater just like that there. Yes, I'm gonna place a block there with a repeater on that was, yeah, now it's 2 tick with a block there and redstone on top. And completely doing this in the wrong order, but that does not matter at all. Now I'm going to place blocks around like this. Exactly the same as here. Signal strength on this side is perfect. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. No, we don't have the right signal strength. Oh, we do need a repeater there, by the way. Repeated there on 2 ticks. Yes, it's right after that slab. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Perfect. I should know that because that one's... yeah. Okay, so now we're going to place in our pistons, I believe. The first lot of pistons is going to be straight down from there, yes. More, and one more line, so you're just going to do... sorry for the rain, by the way. I didn't even notice that. Get rid of that. Okay. Please leave in the comments if this tutorial is okay to follow and you are liking this. And set a few placing blocks along here, because those are going to be in the ceiling. And we are pretty much done. Not too much more to go. We're going to place redstone there, more redstone here, redstone, 4 tick repeater, 3 tick repeater right there, yes, good. In place a redstone block right there with a piston pushing into there with a slab here, and this is when you're gonna grab your comparator there, a upwards facing dropper there, hopper there. I forgot the fern, sorry. You need a fern? For some reason I didn't actually test this, but where am I? In the design, Majima Games said that you need a fern, it's necessary, so I don't see why a fern would be necessary. I don't know what output it actually gives, what the difference of that would be, but fern, apparently. Should have tested that. Why am I getting a new torch out? Silly me. Okay, torch there. That does a little bit of stuff. Block there with another torch on top. I'm pretty sure... What the heck happened there? I am so sorry. To the side of this block, you know, with a redstone block there. And then this is where you could have just... I did have a repeater there on 4 ticks. That made a little slower, but the thing is, you need an extra tick now for everything to work. So you're going to have to go out like this with a 3 tick repeater and a 2 tick repeater. And I think we are done. Let's just give this a go. Those go out, push all the bookshelves up. No. Okay, so we have missed something. Let me find what it is. I don't know what I have missed, but... Oh, of course we have. Of course. Right now I remember. You need a redstone torch. Let me just go around and show you in here, right after this repeater, on the middle line of redstone. That will fix it. Sorry if the sound is extremely loud. I think I can turn that... No, I can't. I'm not going to talk over the pistons, I'm sorry, I'm actually... What? So unprofessional. 100%, heck, should be down like 20%, so loud. Okay, so we still have messed up. They do an extra extension. See, I might be forgetting something extremely important, and that would be this redstone right there. One block of redstone. You could have been shouting at me that that redstone needed to be there. Of course it's logic. Perfect! Okay, so now we have our system finished. We're just going to go and grab our bookshelves. Okay, my bricks aren't spazzing out. I don't have the faith. I changed the faithful text pack a bit and made the bricks animated, but I don't have the faithful text pack on right now. Right, so we are going to place our blocks up like this and chuck our floor in, whatever blocks you want. I have just have these in my hands and do that like this, and then your ceiling in here like this. You're going to need to place blocks just above this redstone here along the back, so you don't have ugly redstone eyes. You're going to be seeing stuff because those bookshelves will go down. I have actually been thinking of making a new design of this with... Where is it? We're going to have more bookshelves on the front as well, so we're going to have a row of bookshelves along here as well. So when you're standing in the room, I'm going to put the pressure plate here. It's going to be a bit more of a tight squeeze with all the redstone, but I might actually try that. So the pressure plate will be there, and then we have more bookshelves coming up there. But now we're going to test this. We're going to have a enchanting table right there. That goes down and it works like a charm. Might have a few glitches if I just... No, not music sound. Video settings. If I know what those are, video settings. Video settings. If I put the render distance all the way down. Bit of fog. That should make it less glitchy. It's alright. Okay, so yeah, the tutorial's finished. This thing works amazing. Doesn't work. I mean, it works slightly different to this one. For some reason I have no idea. That is slower because I just haven't added the other thing in here. They've speeded up. So this module is exactly the same as this one, but I had to extend all the repeaters and put that one there because nothing worked for some stupid reason. So I'm going to stop rambling on. You have it here. I'm just going to tell you a few extra things. Aesthetically pleasing blocks along all of these here. The ceiling can be aesthetically pleasing. You're going to want to put aesthetically pleasing blocks with this redstone on top because you're going to be seeing those right there. Your wall is going to be along here. Don't worry, you're not going to have redstone there. Your wall is going to be like this. Hopefully I'm correct. This wall up like that. And now you have extremely prettiness of a enchanting thingy. You can actually... No, you can't wall it up here. You've got... Actually... You could have your wall right here. Like, right... What am I doing? Like, you could have your wall... Your, like, base... You know, a main room coming right off here because... See? This is all covered up. And then you're going to have a floor here. So yeah, this is extremely epic. The redstone is tiny for a thingy like this. You know, I tried to compact this as much as I could. I failed a teensy little bit. Yes, no. I failed a teensy bit on this. These pistons pushing out for the stuff, but other than that, it is extremely compact. There we are. Now it's completely flush. Completely flush. Right. I am going to stop. See you guys later. Sorry that I didn't have UHC out 2 days ago, 2 or 3 days ago on Wednesday. And get round to that. Okay. I will see you guys later.